Okay, I will walk you over SAP assignment 3, which is an advanced portal content. I will teach you how to create two iViews from remote source, one SAP ERP transaction iView and an iView using RSS news feeds. Then we will create pages and work sets. Okay, so first let's log in to the portal. Okay, and then get into your own folder. Okay, so I have used FLU003, that's my login. LU003 is my login, FLU003 is my folder. So you get into your own folder, then you come to your iView and then highlight iView, right click, and then create a new iView. So I go to new, I go to iView. And then this time, not iView from a template, but iView from remote source, okay? So I do that. Then what I have to do is, I have to select a system here, and I will select Oxford, which is OXF, okay? Then what I have to do is, I have to search for, asterisks included. I have to search for a transaction, and so I will search for cells. Okay, so let's search for cells and see what I come up with. So I come back here and I search for cells, and I say go. Okay, I think I have to fix something else too. So let me go back. I have to have application type transaction. That's what I didn't fix. So I have to have application type transaction cells, and I go, and then it comes up. Okay, all these things, all these applications transactions with cells comes up. So for our assignment, what we have to do is, we are interested in a specific transaction which is called AL08. So we will search for that. And let's see what comes up. So I will search for AL08 and I will say go. Okay, so users logged on came up, and what I have to do is highlight users logged on, and then click on next and click on start upload, and then I have to do finish. So I click on this. Okay, and okay, so I have to highlight, okay, users logged on, then I have to click upload, and then I finish. So I click upload, and then I finish. Okay, so in the process you will see a users logged on iView created here. So after I created the users logged on iView, I have to preview that and make sure that I will allow pop-ups and allow access. So let me preview what I have created here. This is a transaction which will allow me user log on. So okay, so I have to allow, so I allowed it, and you will see that usual lockdown system came up. So it's basically working. Let it work on it, but you can see from here that this is my new iView, which is basically a ERP transaction iView. Okay, the next iView that I have to create is from an RSS news feeds. Okay, so let's do that. So this one is basically from template. Okay, and then I have to choose an XML iView, and after that I have to put in the XML source. Okay, and so let me try that. It's still working, the lockdown. Let's see, it's still working. Okay, let it work. Let me create the new iView. So I will come here, right click, okay, so it has come up. See, users logged on, and I have been able to log on to the system, and it is showing me the list of all users that are in the system. Okay, so I close it, and now I go back to my next iView. So I right click, I say new, I say iView. This time it's iView from template. Okay, and I'm creating XML iView. So here XML iView, and then I do next. Okay, so what is my name? What is the name of this iView? The name is business news and business news. So I will put in business news. Business news. Next. Okay, here I have to define the XML source. How do I define the XML source? Okay, what it tells me is that I have to go to npr.org/RSS. Okay, click on any RSS news feed such as business, and then copy the URL appearing in the browser. So let me open a browser, and here in the new tab, okay, I will paste that. Okay, then I click on business. Okay, and I copy this. So I do Control C, I copy this. Okay, and I come back here. What I have to do is I have to Control V. So I have it here. Okay, and then I just say next. And select RSS to XHTMLB. Okay, so the next, second one. So let me go back. I go to next. I select RSS to XHTMLB file, and then I go to next, and I say finish. Okay, open the object for editing. So once I open the object for editing, basically I do not have any work, I just have to preview. So I go here, I just go to preview. See, it is working fine. So I'm fine, and so I can close it. And what I have to do is take a screenshot of the two iViews that you have just now created. So make sure that you take a screenshot of these two iViews, business news and user logged on. Okay, these are the ones that you have created. So you are here in page 6. Okay, now then you have to create a page 3 for the users logged on iView, and you have to create a page 4 for the business news iView. Okay, so page 3 and page 4. So I come to pages, then I just right click, I say new page. This is page 3. Okay, next, default, this is fine, and I finish. I go to page, then I add users logged on, remember? So I right click, add page, iview to page, delta link, save, preview. So it's working. And then I just close it. So I've created page 3. Now I have to create page 4. So right click. Page 4. Next. Finish. Then I content. Go to the content. Business news. Right click. Add iview to page. Delta link. And then I save it, close it. So now I have to take a screenshot of the pages, okay, which will show page 3 and 4. And then what I have to do is take a screenshot of the open work set that you have created. So I have to also add the pages to the work set. Okay, no problem. So I will go to the work set now. I'll go to the workset folder, open it, open, right click, maybe open workset. Okay, now I add page 3 and 4. So right click on page 3, add to workset, delta link, right click on page 4, add to workset, delta link. So you are done. That's about it.